I just got the latest 5G phone. Okay, that's a lie. No, I didn't. Because 5G is not actually a thing yet. G stands for generation, and every generation is supposed to be separated by a drastic increase in speed, mainly being 1,000 times faster than the previous G. First, there was 1G. Imagine old school 1980s Wall Street, bigwigs with their phones the size of bricks. These phones, as barbaric and rudimentary as they were, still worked. Poorly, but they worked. Wireless phone calls are now a thing, with transfer speeds of 2.4 kilobits per second. And at the time, that was the most incredible thing you'd ever experience. Man, was life tough in the 80s. Low bar. But you arguably didn't see anything resembling a modern phone until the early 1990s, when 2G became a thing. 1,000 times faster than previous phones, 2G phones now included features like texting, email, web browsing, a camera phone,
and download speeds of up to 100 kilobits per second.
None of those things were any good by today's standards, but they existed, and that's something. I mean, you could send the poorest quality pictures to your friends. How exciting was that? Remember? A decade-ish later came 3G, another 1,000 times faster than 2G,
with 2 megabits per second and actual usable web browsing.
This is where the iPhone grabbed the world by the SIM card, because this is where the Gs truly started to matter. Blurry pictures and extremely slowly sent emails were nothing compared to the capabilities of 3G. You could watch high-quality YouTube videos with 3G and have them play back relatively seamlessly. You could browse the web comfortably instead of wanting to gouge your own eyes out with a spork because of how slowly pages used to load. Then things got really interesting. 4G came along, and it should have been the coolest thing since sliced bread. 1,000 times faster than the best thing around sounds pretty incredible. Too much to handle, almost. But the rules were changed, and this generation upgrade wasn't true 4G by the old standards. It was really more like 3G plus. Instead of being a 1,000 times upgrade, it was really only 100 times faster than 3G. By the time true 4G came around, it was dubbed 4G long-term evolution, or as you probably know better, LTE. Why? Because everybody knows if you add extra letters and numbers to something nobody understands, it'll make them think it's smarter and better because it's new.
4G actually got you 12 megabits per second.
And that's what led to real opportunity for video consumption on platforms like YouTube and new TV streaming services. It's what you probably have in your phone right now, and sure, it's buggy at times and slow, but it's also incredible, the cutting edge of technology for what we have right now. What's next? What's the thing that's gonna get you jazzed for your next phone? It's called 5G. 5G can enable download speeds of 1 gigabyte to 3.5 gigabytes per second. In content consumption terms, that means you could download an 8 gigabyte HD movie in 6 seconds. 6 seconds! That's faster than you can pirate an HD movie over Wi-Fi. Of course, it's gonna be a long and tough road until we get there, setting up the infrastructure to make it possible and getting the new world to adapt. The beginnings of 5G are already taking place. AT&T ran 5G tests late last year in Texas, and by the end of this year, 7 out of the 10 biggest cities in Britain are gonna be a testing ground for Vodafone's 5G. Nationwide 5G coverage is still a few years away, but we're getting closer than ever. And I don't know about you, but I can't wait to experience the future of cellular data transfer.